But our first bit of unexpected London is right here. Yes, across the road is Hyde Park, and not a stone's throw away is the Marble Arch. But our surprise is around this corner.
A mews in the heart of London, with riding stables, and where totters still come to have their horses shod. Two farriers still work here, but today they have to travel to make a living. Wally Baker is an old hand. Fred Hammond is a youngster by comparison, with a portable forge that he tows in a trailer.
Yeah, can I ask you, Wally, how many years have you been doing this job?
Oh, I should imagine about 50 or something like that. Somewhere around about that.
How old were you when you left school?
14 when I left 14, school in 1926.
That's 53 years.
Yeah, well... The first 3 years we wasn't sure, we was only shop boy. Yeah,
but it was learning the trade.
Oh, yes, learning the trade, yes. And, well, about 4 year army service, I never wasn't sure during the war.
Yeah, but weren't you with horses at all during the last
war? No, I was a blacksmith in the last war, in the Royal Engineers.
Oh, very nice, so, too. Like, you missed the horses, though.
Yeah, we missed the horses, yeah.
Can I ask you, Wally, now, can you make a living nowadays?
Well, myself, I don't want to make the living. I've retired. I only do one or two a day, like, just to keep myself in practice.
If you're prepared to travel,
yes,
there's not enough work in London. I used to be in partnership,
yes,
but there wasn't enough work, so we had to split.
So you just move around from different muses?
County to county.
I see. Because you've got your little car and you've got your what would you call that? Your forge, I suppose.
Well, it's a portable forge. Trailer, yeah.
How do you make it operate?
Well, it's quite simple. It's an old car blower unit. It runs off your battery, same as electricity would.
So it's like the old blacksmith brought right up to date?
Well, that's the only way you do it.
Yes.
The days before, they used to come to you, but now you go to them.
Well, it's as I say, I travel by a bus or tube and, you know, just go and do one and
you've got your pensioner's pass.
Oh, yeah, I use that. So
and what about your tools? How do you just...
Just carry in a bag, that's all I take, and... do most of them cold chewing now, like, you know.
Do you?
I know me animal as near as. I know each horse I do.
What the name of this one you're doing now, this
is
customer.
Basil, and that's old Albert holding his head.
Oh, that's Basil, and that's Albert holding his head. Is he a good one?
He's nice and kind, he is, yes. He's only a babe. Well, he ain't all that old.
Do you mean the horse is nice and kind, or Albert?
Well, Albert ain't too bad when you catch him in the right mood.
Albert, how often do you bring Basil here to be chewed?
Roughly every 6-7 weeks.
Expensive, isn't it, for you?
Yes.
How much does it cost you, Albert, to have them shoot?
Well, time you give Wally a drink, the farrier, is round about a tenner.
Tenner. So you've got to go out earning.
And you lose a day's work.
Yes. But what about the business today? What's it like, totting?
Very empty. The last 3 or 4 months, the weather's been against us.
Well, just like now.
We've been scratching.
Yeah. Well, I hope the weather improves for all of us and for all totters.
Yes, it's very
nice
kind of you,
a real steptoe. How long have you been doing this?
About 30 years.
Well, keep it up, you're used to it. Cheerio, Baz. Keep it up, mate, is a nice old
He's got
horse,
a new, nice set of shoes on.
Yes, he's got a real posh when
they'll
he gets
be,
back.
They'll be able to hear him coming now. I won't have to shout so loud.
Totters, throw him out.
Is that what he's...
Come on, son. Up. Right. Now we'll see if we made a mistake.
Good fit?
Wants a bit more off the toe. It's what we call letting the clipping.
Oh, I see. You can't really stretch them like you do a pair of shoes, can you?
Well, you can do.
Can you?
Oh, yeah. But if they don't fit right, you don't nail them on right.
Yes. Well, I'm sure Ben will be very satisfied by the time you're finished.
Oh, yeah. He'll enjoy it.
Oh, dear, dear. Stinks a bit, doesn't it?
Right.
Now, what happens now?
Dip it in water.
Right. Careful how you go. Just like the old shoe cobblers, you have them in your mouth.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's convenient, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's well done. But, it takes it out of you. Have you got big muscles?
No, not really. It's neck more than strength.
Yes.
Fred, do you ever find any difficult horses?
Oh, not many.
Really?
Yeah, I've had some nasty knock-ups.
Nasty ones? What have they done to you?
Well, little things like break your toes, break your leg, serious ones, smash your ribs, fracture your skull.
You've had a fractured skull?
Not one, a double fracture.
Let's have a look.
One there.
Oh, dear. I want to still see the scar. Well, what makes them do that? I always thought horses, you know, were very polite.
They're like people. They can get irritable.
Yes.
They can be upset. Slightest thing, like a car coming by them. They don't intend to do it, but they just do it.
But they do. They do. But you still love them, obviously.
You wouldn't do the job unless you felt for an animal, would you?
Yes.
Well, it's not easy job. There's nothing easy about it. They simply make it easier by we ain't got the old pump-up bellers and all that, like you know.
Yes. But for instance, when you first started chewing horses, how much did you charge?
When I first started, as the boy, it was about 4 shillings a set in old money.
And how much do you charge now?
Well, it varies, like, from about 5, 6 or something like that. It's all according how deep their pocket is.
And sometimes 10 quid a pair.
Yes, if you can get it.
Yes. Now, Wally, when I think horses, are they different, some of the horses?
Every horse is an individual in his own rights. Like, you know, you can get them naughty, wicked, or you can get them as kind and, you know.
Just like people.
Exactly like people. Yes, they're, as I say, they're individuals.